The next speaker is, if people want to come over here, there are some seats. People right over there might not know that. The next speaker is Micheline Mason, who I've known forever, and who used to write books of Richard, and now writes wonderful poetry, and has campaigned tirelessly for inclusive education most of her life, and she's going to do some poems for us.
Thank you. I think it's this. I've written two new poems. One I finished, had it not been edited. I've been starting it about 5 years ago, but I finally finished it. The number one I've written especially for tonight. I think the whole issue of language and disability is very complex. But language shapes the way we think. It's very, very profoundly important. And the first poem is really, it speaks for itself really, but it is about the way people have been persuaded to see us and the way, the effect that that can have on them, on our lives. And it refers to a piece of history that's been talked about by other speakers here about eugenics and the times when disabled people were separated and locked up in long-stay hospitals and asylums.
Could you speak
for
louder, please?
Sorry?
Louder.
Louder. Is this on?
He's going to turn it up.
If I put it nearer, okay. So, it's about a real woman. She was called Susan Miller. She was hospitalised from the age of one in 1921 after catching polio. It is called A Thousand Buttonholes. When she grew to be a young adult, they taught her to sew, because that's what the women in these institutions had to do. And she hated sewing, and she was no good at sewing. And they'd started her off on buttonholes and said, if you don't, you know, and when you can do a decent buttonhole, we'll move you on to something else. And she never did a decent buttonhole, because she never got moved on to anything else. That's why it's called A Thousand Buttonholes. When I was a little girl, to be a dancer was my dream. Swaying to the beating rhythms, my whole body proudly seen. Appearing on the stage, I would skip and spin and twirl, losing myself in stirring music. Skirts around me would whirl. I could do it in my own way. My gift for others to see, my audience delighted, I imagined, in the startling dancing me. But they could not see my dancer self. They saw only something broken. They netted me like a butterfly, locked me up, no words spoken. My crime was catching polio, a lifetime sentence given. They had me sewing buttonholes in their long-stay hospital prison. I stitched 1,000 buttonholes while dreams faded into tears. No dances, only buttonholes to mark my passing years. When I was a little girl, I dreamt of being a bride, all decked out in a wedding dress, my father by my side. Appearing at the top of the aisle, I would lean on my daddy's arm, blushing and smiling together, excited but inwardly calm. My groom so proudly waiting to wrap me in a lifelong embrace, a partner to share our journey, happy to live at my pace. But they did not want my bride self. They saw only something broken. They netted me like a butterfly and locked me up, no words spoken. My crime was catching polio, a lifetime sentence given. They had me sewing buttonholes in their old state hospital prison. I stitched 1,000 buttonholes while dreams faded into tears. No husband, only buttonholes marked my path in years. When I was a little girl, I dreamt of becoming a mother. All decked out in maternity clothes, my body giving life to another. Settled in my own warm house, my loving heart creating a home. Cuddling and kissing, feeding and bathing, until my little one had grown. But they would not allow my mother self. They saw only something broken. They netted me like a butterfly, locked me up, no words spoken. My crime was catching polio, a lifetime sentence given. They had me sewing buttonholes in their Longstead hospital prison. I stitched 1,000 buttonholes while dreams faded into tears. No babies, only buttonholes to mark my passing years. And this is a poem I wrote after Richard and I had one of our conversations. And I hope it speaks for itself. It's called Cry Out for Words of Freedom. Weighed down by leaden words, caged by history's judgments, we, the misshapen, the crippled, we the halt and the lame, we the diseased, deformed and invalid, we the spazzies, the mongs and the crazies, we cry out for words of freedom. Words can reflect to us our beauty, tell our unique stories of hope, raise us up with spoken recognition, celebrate the humanity we give back. Label us with our untold gifts. Bind us to our shared humanity. Fan flame of our recreation. Herald our phoenix, not our ashes, so we can truly know ourselves. Our ways of life cause injury. Harsh systems destroy our health. We are you, and you are us. No mountains of wealth can buy protection. There's no personal immunity for sale, no escape from the air we're poisoned, the people, the plants, and the planet. Cry out for words of freedom to heal our ailing world. And we have to recognise that the world is making people very sick in many, many ways. And perhaps we're the strongest people to start challenging our behaviour, right?